As the debate continues about the nation's new health reform law, in the courts and on the campaign trail, the Kansas Health Institute has asked some experts to share their views. These interviews with providers, public officials, and people on the business side of healthcare are intended to help Kansans better understand how the law will affect them and help them sort fact from fiction and policy from politics.
The problems of healthcare really are the problems of insurance. The first problem is something that we call adverse selection. And adverse selection occurs when people who think they're going to suffer a loss will tend to get insurance more than people who don't expect to suffer a loss. So in the extreme case in health insurance, you might wait until you got sick to get insurance coverage. The second problem of insurance is what's called moral hazard. That's what happens when the existence of insurance causes you to behave differently than you would if you didn't have insurance. In our health insurance system, we pay for things on a fee-for-service basis. So there's no disincentive for a healthcare provider to economize on what kind of care they give. They might as well give you more care, and you assume that you're gonna get better care if you get more care. Well, the individual mandate and some other things in the healthcare law deal with that first problem of adverse selection. But you can solve that problem. You can get everybody into the current system, and you'll still have the underlying problem of the incentive that healthcare providers have to provide more care and more expensive care. How do you get somebody to go to your hospital instead of someplace else? Well, maybe you invest in a really expensive medical device and you advertise, we have this, your surgeries will be better, more comfortable because we have this robotic medical device. Well, that device costs millions of dollars. How do they justify that expenditure? They're gonna have to use it. And so if there's any reason why they might want to use it, they're gonna use it. The competition, particularly given that we have a third-party payer, actually sometimes increase costs. A lot of times you hear about preventive care as kind of a panacea to the problems of healthcare costs. It makes intuitive sense that if you get people to get the right checkups and do the right stuff, that they'll impose fewer costs on the system down the road. The problem is there really aren't very good data out there that suggests that giving preventive care at point X is gonna cut costs in the system at, say, X plus 3 years or X plus 5 years. That may end up being true, but we just don't have good data right now. And so I think it's important not to use something like that as kind of a quick fix or an easy answer. Politics surrounding this issue are frustrating. You have these competing narratives in the political process that are mostly beside the point. On the one hand, you have a narrative that suggests that it's basically a problem of greed, where you've got, you know, greedy big corporations that are kind of rigging the system so people can't get the healthcare they need. The problem with that is that we have the same basic dynamic in our public programs in Medicare. They have the same issue with the incentives that it gives doctors, with the unnecessary care that it promotes, and with the cost that we apparently will have moving on into the future. The other narrative is that if we simply unleash the free market, if we just unleash the magic of the marketplace, that everything will be solved there. Well, as we know, there are problems in healthcare. There are problems in health insurance that simply letting it go on its own merry way won't solve. There are these incentives that we have for providers to give more care and more expensive care that we're gonna need to deal with, and there are gonna have to be rules to deal with that. So it can't just be pure competition on the one hand, but it can't just be a government solution on the other hand. Neither of those really fit the problems that we have. Those of us who are in the industry, in healthcare and in health insurance and health policy, it is extraordinarily important, maybe the most important thing that we can do in our public life is to solve this problem, to be able to allow people to find affordable healthcare and have a good quality of life. It's hard to imagine something that's more important than that.